6% unemployment rate is seen as low and in fact good on a global scale. Now, some countries have unemployment rates in the mid to high 20s, such as Greece with 27.4% unemployment. Spain has a 26% rate, while in South Africa it's just over 25%.
Now, these sort of figures lead to countries being considered broken economies by analysts and often indicate high youth unemployment. But rather staggeringly, despite our 6% overall unemployment rate in Australia, our youth unemployment rate rivals those regions, sitting at about 23% in the 15 to 19 year old demographic.
So are we creating a lost generation of workers who will never enjoy a career and the life that comes with it? For more this morning, we're joined by social researcher Mark McCrindle. Good morning, Mark. Thanks for joining us.
Sure.
So what do we make of these figures? Should we be concerned?
Yeah, certainly below that headline unemployment rate figure, which, you know, is not too bad, as you've seen, compared to other nations, we do have some problems, particularly with young people. I mean, this is the start of their formative years, their economic life, and when you've got about one in four young people, 15 to 19, who are not in full-time education and who can't get a job, we've got an issue. Even if you take the 15 to 24-year-olds, nationally, we've got an unemployment rate, well, in some areas like Cairns and Tasmania, above 20%. So it's up there with some of those challenged economies.
So where is the issue here? There's not enough jobs for young people, or are employers not willing to take on younger workers?
We have had a bit of a slowdown in the economy, and particularly a lot of those starting jobs, those entry-level jobs. That's where employers have sort of cut those roles to save some money. The other problem, of course, is that employers are now looking for experience. And when you're starting out, that's one thing you don't have. So that's the challenge for young people as they get started. And the research shows that if someone leaves full-time education and within a year is not in full-time earnings, then that starts to set a bit of an unemployment trajectory for their future.
So, Mark, concerning these developments and trend, does there need to be a national strategy to try and tackle this issue?
Yeah, there does need to be a comprehensive look at this. I mean, if we had an unemployment figure of, you know, double digits, let alone one in four, it would be a national disaster. And yet that's what we've got with a young generation in Australia. So it certainly needs to be looked at. We need some solutions. And it's not just about getting older workers out of jobs. I think that we don't need to solve the unemployment of one generation by, you know, looking at the employment of another. I think older workers and employers can help solve the problem by offering some of those training and mentoring positions, and by looking at a national training strategy and ensuring that in a focus on higher education, we have, you know, young people who don't head that way who can still get some trades or entry-level positions.
Mark, thanks for your insight this morning.
Thank you.
Ahead this morning, our week...